We're ready to hang out with you guys. Welcome aboard.
Back to the moon, the Artemis program, we're going to be there in 5 years and then stay there and figure out how to get to Mars and do that safely. And all of that is going to be predicated on understanding how space affects the human body. So we spanned the entire spectrum up here.
Hiding an emotional problem, I realized, was like returning to the Dark Ages. And I don't think we can watch men walk on the moon and be in the Dark Ages.
It's time to get clean.
I gotta tell you, life aboard the International Space Station is amazing every day. It's full of surprises, it's full of exciting science that we're accomplishing.
We could sort of work on a flat plane.
It's just more far-fetched. So, okay.
Whatever. Flat Earth, that's far-fetched.
Yeah, exactly. All right.
We've got a team spread across the globe.
Laboratory module, and the first thing I want to show you is how we heat up these green packages of food. And these are a lot like the what's called MREs in the military, meals ready to eat. And matter of fact, I think they come from the same company that the U.S. military uses. So I'll heat up this or rehydrate this asparagus, and I basically just put it in here and. Normally don't do this from this position. And I'll put 50 milliliters of hot water in there to heat it up. And believe it or not, the water that is produced from our urine actually tastes better than any tap water I've ever tasted in the United States. It's on the sweet side for me, but not too bad.
Are they safe or potentially harmful? Why?
I might add, it's color coded, so you really don't get it mixed up, which is nice. This is yellows for number one.
It's really wet.
Fluff. Two options. Swallow it.
Yes, I think it's what keeps me looking so youthful, but I don't like it in my eyeball.
Keep a pair of scissors, Velcro, my magnetic case with my needles, my spool of thread.
I like fluffernutters.
Especially as we start going deeper into space.
Or you can just spit it out in a paper towel.
And it just every day is full of new things. And
see how much better the brush makes my hair look? I'm just joking. It still stands up straight. It doesn't matter where you are. It's always going to stand up straight while you're up in space.
Just this past week, I was working on an experiment where we were testing out the way rubbers are made and maybe that we can make better rubbers.
Like I said, sometimes things get a little out of control if you are out of control yourself flying around. So we have lots of protective stuff. And of course, you do have your privacy. There's a little door.
So it's a lot of complicated science to make this all work.
And even the lids on the peanut butter have a piece of Velcro on it so they don't go floating away.
It's far from being a masterpiece, but it was made in space.
Because I'm in space, and I can, I get to name these yo-yo tricks as I invent them. So I call this Shoot the Planets. It's basically uncontrolled. The string is limp, and it's just bouncing back and forth. So this trick is the asteroid. You have to be careful, because if it comes back in an uncontrolled way, it can end up hitting you in the head.
Especially as we start going deeper into space, which is going to be very important as we go back to Mars in the next 5 years.
One of the neat things about video is that you can edit out all these things when you goon it up, you know?